Hello. Topic 108. What are three things you can do to integrate the trans community into the general population? Be specific, and then pledge to do one. Alternative option. Be specific. Explain how someone else can do one. Number one. Just be. Easier said than done, isn't it? And let others be. Easier said than done, isn't it? Isn't it, kitty? Yeah. The cats are not taking very well to having Lucy in the house. That's our dog. And they have not quite found a way to coexist as two separate types of creatures. And they have the same likes and dislikes and mannerisms, and they both need attention and nurturing. I mean, they're creatures, they're life. And they need the respect that makes calamity of so long life, which is a line from Hamlet. Of course, I'm sure you all know that, because everybody's read Hamlet, right? Right? Yeah. And I know those of you who haven't read To Kill a Mockingbird are on that this week, and that's great. I have spent the summer letting my leg hair grow in, and my skin feels better. I feel better. I feel less ridiculous, less exposed for no reason. And I quite like it, and I think I'll keep it. I've also, in the last week or so, been letting my sideburns and my chin hair, all of this is growing in. I'm just trying to let my skin heal from the summer, really. But wearing it to work has been kind of fascinating, because I see people trying not to look at it. And I don't care. I'm there to do my job, and I do a good job because I love the work that I do. So, yeah, I'm fine just being and letting others be. There are some of my users who are uncomfortable with who I am. And, of course, that's not because of my fantastic social skills. No. I don't know. I think it's because they just don't know how to react to someone who's highly technical. And I know that's not what you were expecting to hear, but it's the truth. When I'm at work, when I'm out somewhere to do something, that's the priority. And when I gotta go, I really don't care what the sign says on the bathroom, because I'm not there to socialize. And I assure you that nobody wants to socialize there with me. Okay, option number two. Make a playlist of inspirational songs that people may not know in all different genres. Just a few on my list. And I will put this, I'll put this list on our Facebook page. If you go over to Facebook and search for Tranny Star Galactica, you'll find us. And I'll start a thread, so this will be an easy one for everybody to do. So just stop by our Facebook page and go ahead and post your playlist, and let's see if maybe we get some new music out there. James Maddock, When You Go Quiet. Owl City, Tidal Wave. Khaki King, QP Station. Imogen Heap, Bad Body Double. In Flames, Acoustic Medley. Moxie Frubis, Kickin' the Ass. Try those on, see how they fit. If they don't, put some up on the Facebook page. We'd love to hear from you. Third's a tough one, because not all of us are talkers. But for those of you who are, please use appropriate language. By appropriate, I mean, use language that you need to use to communicate what you need to. I came up with this idea, drop the F-bomb. And I know I'm going to offend some people here. I can't not. But I'm just going to throw it out there as a discussion and put a question mark at the end and see what comes up. And anybody who has any concerns about what I say, of course, I'm glad to discuss anything and see if we can settle up somehow. All right, all that aside, drop the F-bomb. Use pejoratives like fag and dyke if you need to. If that's what you feel like you need to say, use it and take the power out of them. Bring them back down to the level of common words and it won't be a big deal. And here's why I think this, and this is just a hypothesis. We have discussions about whether to use the N-word. And we say one population can use it, but another can't. And we call that bias from either direction. And we've learned a lot about sexism through what we've learned about racism historically. The civil rights movement has taught us so much. And we can learn how to deal with pejoratives, I think, by maybe modernizing that conflict to today's use of the N-word. Perhaps it's the adoption of the N-word by the minority group that took the power out of its use. And it was not a noble act by white people's reluctance to use it. And sure, let's go there. I'm going to let you in on a little secret. They're not all that reluctant. It's just that white people don't like to say that word in front of black people, and they'll often precede it by, I'm not racist, but. And that is something that absolutely bothers me, because there's no kind of cultural attaché there. There's no point to that. So I'm not saying that this is appropriate. I'm just saying that it exists, and maybe there's a concept there that we may have overlooked. So is it appropriate for a minority group to use a word that the rest of society uses as a pejorative? And can using the word neutrally reduce the amount of power that the word has? So how do we apply this to trans language? You can start using her and ze as gender-neutral pronouns instead of his and her and he and she. I've written all of my academic papers for the last 2 years using those, and I just put a footnote at the bottom that says, I intend to use a gender-neutral pronoun. I have not lost points for that yet. So, what about the labels? What about trans and gay? Can you be trans and gay? Well, sure. One is your sexuality and one's your identity. So an unfortunate pitfall of our place at the end of the LGBT acronym is that each identity operates independently. So people don't think in reading the acronym that you can be more than one of those things. And what they do instead, you know, they expand the acronym into LGBTQQIA. You know, no matter how many options you have, no matter how far you expand that acronym, you can only choose one. And I have no solution for this, but I'll take suggestions. This is just an observation on how we use language and how language limits us. There's a lot of different hypotheses on how language works, but if you're feeling curious, I think that would be a way to start making language that works as pejoratives or language that does not exist more appropriate, so that we can start validating our place in society. Society will adapt. It's what society does. Populations emerge and society figures it out. That's how it goes. So I will make the playlist, and that will be the one thing that I pledge to do. Appropriate language I already do. Just be and let others be is easier said than done, but I'm going to give it my best shot. Special thanks to Courtney for her support in assembling this video and helping me find a voice on a very bad day. Same goes for Diana. Thank you both, and I love you both very much.